Oh, they say anything to you?
Yes, well, perhaps you are.
Well, the same as anyone can be, like you see. I said, ah, you know, Henry, I've been very worried about Lucy.
Worried? Why?
She just doesn't seem to realize there are certain things she can't do.
How did you come like that?
Well, she's always on the way of things. I don't suppose there's another woman in the world who could flout the traditions of government house as she. Most of the guys catch a toe the line of convention, but not our Lucy. Oh, dear me, no. She played merry help of precedence at dinner parties. That, my dear Henrietta, is the blackest of crimes. She put deadly enemies next to each other. She ran riot for the colour question. And instead of people being at loggerheads, I'm damned if she didn't get away with it. It's that old trick of hers, always smiling at people who feel sweet and helpless. It's the same with servants. She gives them any amount of trouble, and they simply adore her.
I know what you mean. Things that you wouldn't stand from anyone else seem perfectly all right when Lucy does them. What is it, charm? Pit, does it?
I don't know. She's been the same since a girl. But you know, Henrietta, it is growing on her. She just does not seem to realize there are limits. I really believe that Lucy would feel that she could get away from her.
Oh, darling Henry, you and Lucy are such angels letting me make my mess here, treading clay into your carpet. When I had the fire at my studio, I thought it was the end of everything. It's so sweet of you to let me move in with you.
My dear, we're so proud of you. Why, I've just been reading a whole article about you and your show here in the Times.
Where?
Page there, I believe.
The most significant piece of the year.
Conversation has to take the most astonishing leaps, with all the connections.
do wish you'd come to Ainswick more often, Lucy. It's looking so beautiful just now.
Oh, Lucy, darling. Excuse me, m'lady, but Mrs. Medway would like to see you a moment. It's something not savoury for dinner.
Chicken livers, which has had no conscience when it comes to chicken livers. Don't tell me they haven't arrived.
Oh, no, they haven't arrived. Mrs. Medway's a little dubious about
them. I sometimes wonder whether Lucy minds very much about Ainswick.
How do you mean?
Her home. If she'd been born a boy, it would have gone to her instead of me. What if she resents it?
Oh, no, not the way that you mean. The Agathas stick together. They even marry their cousins.
She does care very much about Ainswick.
Oh, Lucy cares more for Ainswick than anything in the world. That picture is the dominating note of this house. If you think that Lucy resents you, you're wrong, Edward.
I never quite understand, Lucy. Most extraordinary charm.
Lucy's the most adorable creature I know. And the most maddening.
Agatha! Lovely to see you.
How's Ainswick?
It's looking so beautiful just now.
Midge, darling, how are you?
You want to come, Henrietta?
Yes, I know I ought. What fun we had there as children.
Oh, butchers and no better than that.
Yeah. school.
She's doing it for her own good, Doris. She's training you.
Shall I get more money, shall I, when I train?
Not much, I'm afraid.
Don't seem worth being trained then, does it?
Maybe my girl. Trouble is, there are no proper employers nowadays. Nobody knows what's what. Those who have the money to employ servants don't appreciate what a good servant is.
My dad says I ought to call myself a domestic help.
Well, that's not all you are, my girl. Let me tell you, you're lucky to be in a household where wine glasses are used in the proper manner. The master and mistress appreciate highly technical skill. There aren't many employees left nowadays that even notice you went the wrong way around the table.
I still think her ladyship does funny things, picking up that holster now.
Her ladyship is a little absent-minded, not to say to him. But in this house, I see to it, everything possible is done to spare her ladyship trouble and annoyance. That will be Dr. and Mrs. Christie. Go upstairs and be ready to help Simmons with the unpacking.
Thank you.
Children.
What about?
I was wondering how we could manage about the children if we went to South France.
Why should we?
what she was doing on me.
I can't think why she asked you to sit for her. Most extraordinary. I was thinking Barbara's good thing when she came around to greet her, I guess. This winter I'm going to cut down a new tree so there'll be a better view of the lake.
I think that's a very good idea, Edward. Hello, Gerda. How are you? You know Edward I can tell, don't you?
How do you do, Mrs. Christopher?
Where's John? Oh, he's just gone out into the garden to see if he can find Lady Agatha.
Well, it's a terrible garden to find anybody in. It's all trees and shrubs. Oh, and see, there'll be such lovely autumn tints. Yes.
You'll forgive me if I go and change.
Autumn always takes one back. One keeps saying, don't you remember? Oh, look, should we go look for the others too?
No, please. Yes, that would be very nice.
Gerda, why do you come down here when you hate it so much?
Oh, but I don't.
Yes, you do.
Oh, I don't really. It's delightful to get down here into the country, and Lady Agatha is all so kind.
Lucy isn't a bit kind. She has good manners, and she knows how to be gracious.
But I think she's rather a cruel person. Perhaps because she's not quite human.
She doesn't know what it is to think and feel like all. And you are hating it here, Gerda, you know you are.
Oh, you see, John likes it.
Well, John likes it all right, but he couldn't come by himself.
He wouldn't do that. He wouldn't enjoy himself here without me.
Where is it? What is Christie's car away here? Hatfield, remembering what?
The time when I was a long-legged, lanky girl with untidy hair. A happy girl who had no idea what this life could do to her. Just going back.
I should want suddenly want to go back. Why do things you haven't thought of for years suddenly come back into your mind?
What things, John?
The sea, the smell of mimosa.
When?
10 years ago.
And do you want to go back?
I'm so tired. What would I do without you?
Getting on very well, I expect.
Why do things you haven't thought of for years suddenly spring into your mind?
Perhaps because they're not really over and done with.
Not after 10 years. I can't remember how long it is since I thought about it, but lately, even when I'm walking around the wards, it keeps coming back into my mind, and it's as vivid as a picture. And now, on top of it all, she's here, just a few yards down the lane.
Veronica Gray, you mean?
Yes. I was engaged to her once, 10 years ago.
I see.
Crazy young fool. I was mad about her. She had just started in pictures then. I'd been working at Croydon as registrar for about a year when I had this wonderful opportunity to work under Rarely, D.H. Rarely, you know, the authority on cortex degeneration.
What happened?
Well, I might have guessed what happened. Veronica got a chance to go to Hollywood. Well, naturally she took it. But she assumed, without making any bones about it, that I'd give up everything and go with her. No idea how important my profession was to me. I can hear her now. Absolutely no need for you to go on doctoring. I should be making heaps of money. I tried to explain it to her. Randy, what a wonderful opportunity to work on the hip. You know what she said? What? That comic little old man. I told her that that comic little old man had done some of the finest research work of our generation. That his experiments would revolutionize the treatment of Briggs disease. That was a waste of time. She'd never even heard of Briggs disease.
Well, not many people have. I haven't. Told me about it, then I
read it up. She said, who cares about all of the obscure diseases anyway? California was a wonderful climate. It would be fun for me to see the world. But she'd hate to go there without me. Miss Craig was a complete egoist. Never thought of anyone but herself.
You're wrong by way of being egoist yourself, John.
I saw her point of view. Why couldn't she see mine?
Well, what did you suggest?
I told her I loved her. I begged her to give up the Hollywood offer and marry me there and then.
What did she say to that?
She was just amused.
And so?
And so there was only one thing to do. Break it off. It wasn't easy, but I did it. All that was when we were in the south of France. I broke with Veronica and came back to England to work under Radley.
But then you married her?
The following year, yeah.
Why? Yes. Was it because you wanted someone as different as possible from Veronica Gray?
Yes, I suppose that was it. I didn't want a raving beauty for a wife. I didn't want some damned egoist out to grab everything she could get. I wanted safety and peace and devotion and all the quiet, enduring things of life. I wanted someone who'd take her ideas from me.
Well, you certainly got what you wanted. Nobody could be more devoted. Gerda.
That's the irony of it. I picked Gerda for just the qualities that she has, and now half the time I snap her head off because of them. How was I to know how irritating devotion can be?
And, is she satisfied?
Of course, Gerda's all right. She's quite happy.
Is she?
Yes. She spends her time fussing about the children in the house. That's all she thinks about. She's the most incompetent housekeeper, the most injudicious mother you can imagine. Still, it keeps her occupied.
How horribly cruel you are, John.
Me?
You never see or feel anything except from your own point of view. And why do you bring Gerda down here for weekends when you know it's misery for her?
Nonsense! Doesn't the world want to get away from you? Spring for her.
Sometimes, John, I'm afraid.
Henrietta! Oh, darling, don't say that. You know it's only you who makes life possible. Edward say it's rather good. Why, what on earth? So that's why you had Gerda sit for you. How dare you?
I wondered if you'd see it.
See it? Of course I dare not see it.
The face is Gerda's.
No, it's the neck, the shoulders, the whole attitude.
Yes, that's what I wanted.
How could you do a thing like that? It's indefensible.
State.
Oh, I sometimes think it would be the wisest of the family.
But
It's an original point of view. Mm. I've always considered myself a walking example of how to fail in life.
Oh no, it's a question of the right values. You're about to want a stage to read and care for one's horse, not to get caught up in the struggle for material achievement. Oh no, there. That's a pretty far.
One of the perks from our shop.
You can't like working in that shop, Mitch.
Who said I like it?
Well, then why do it?
What do you suggest I should live on? Beautiful thoughts?
My dear girl, if I've any idea.
Save your breath, Edward. She's obstinate. Refused an allowance, won't come and live with us, even though we've begged her to. I couldn't imagine anything nicer than having young Mitch about the house.
Why don't you, Mitch?
I have ideas. Poor, proud, and prejudiced. That's me. They're badgering me, Lucy.
Oh, are they, darling?
I don't like the idea of her working in this dress shop.
Oh, well, find me a better job.
Surely there must be something.
Remember, I have no particular qualifications. Just the ability to remain calm when I'm being shouted at.
Do you mean to say the customers are rude to you?
Oh, abominably rude sometimes. It's their privilege.
Well, my dear girl, that's all wrong. If only I'd known.
How would you know? Your world and mine are so far apart. I'm only half an Agatha. The other half's plain business girl. Unemployment always lurking round the corner in spite of the politician's brave words.
Lovely English words. You're to be
changed her hair. She used to have it flowing down her back.